Check 1 2, 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 A B C D E F G A B C. Welcome, 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 welcome everyone. 1 2 1 2.
Very good. call me and don't feel me near you, will you still trust me? What if I tell you to let go of the very thing that you think you have to hold? Will you trust me? Yes, I'll trust you, Lord. What if it costs my life? Yes, I'll trust you, Lord. What if I lose the very thing I love so dear? Yes. Somebody say, yes, I'll trust you, Lord. Somebody say, yes. Come on, put your hands up and say, yes, I'll trust you. I'll trust you. I'll trust you. I can hear Jesus singing. He says this.
I know the thing is easy when everything is going well, but can you still believe in me when your life's a living hell? Ooh. And when all the things around you seem to quickly fade away, there's just one thing I really want to know. Will you let go?
I'll trust you, Lord.
Stand on my word.
I'll trust you, Lord.
Against all odds, will you believe what I have said?
I'll trust you, Lord.
Seems impossible.
I'll trust you, Lord.
Will you believe?
I'll trust you, Lord.
Every promise that I made, will you receive, my child?
Yes, I will trust you.
I know how bad that you'd never love again, oh my. But will you trust that I can help you, and I'll never turn away, oh my. Will you trust me, child, no matter come what may? What if it hurts?
I will.
This gift to you I bring, a simple offering of praise to you I sing. My grateful heart today, with joy it gives you thanks. You're the truth that lights my way. And with all my gratitude, I lift my hands and worship you. All this love from my heart to your ears, I just wanna say you're the best thing that happened to me.
I'm here with you, there I wanna be. It's clear to see you're the best thing that happened to me. You gave your life just to rescue me. It's clear to see you're the best thing that happened to me.
A loving God you are. You took my broken heart and held it in your hand. Your healing touch was there to show me that you care. Told me to live again. And with all my gratitude, I lift my hands and worship you. All this love from my heart to your ears, I just want to say you're the best thing that happened to me.
I'm here with you,
where I wanna be.
It's clear to see
you're the best thing
that happened to me. You gave your life just to rescue me.
Yeah, yeah.
It's clear to see
you're the best thing.
One thing I know is,
one thing I know is you're
in love.
Falling in love with you.
The best thing I've done. And my life has never been the same.
And with all of my heart, come on somebody, can we all just say it like this?
You're the best.
I like that. Come on, somebody,
you're
say it.
The best thing.
You are the best.
Brothers,
thing.
Let me hear you say it.
You're the best.
Sisters,
you are the best. Thing.
As long as there exists a day and night. Sing it if you don't mean it.
Be strong. my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also.
Please rise as we look to the Lord in prayer at this time. Those who can, if you please stand. Let's call on the Lord. Heavenly Father, we give you thanks this morning for the privilege to be in your presence. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord for his good and his mercy endures forever. We give you thanks this morning for life. And we give you thanks for the life of our deceased sister, Marjorie Wiley Crawford. We need you to come by right now, Lord, and just minister to everyone here. Oh, we need a touch from above. Oh, Lord, come and comfort. Come and console this grieving family. Help them, Lord, to look to you and see, I lift up my eyes to the hill. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. We just rely on you. Thank you for the confidence we have that with Jesus, everything, even at this hour, is going to be all right. And we pray by saying, thanks be to God, who give us the victory through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. You may be seated.
Our Marjorie was a beloved sister, aunt, daughter, cousin, and friend. Born July 21st, 1949, Marjorie Diane Wiley Crawford was, from a young age, a vibrant personality who always sought to expand her horizons. At a young age, she accepted Jesus Christ as her Lord and Savior, and became a member of the Mount Olive Baptist Church in Rankin, PA. A high-stepping majorette while attending Swissvale High School, she moved to Washington, D.C. to attend Howard University after high school. I have to put a pause in the obituary because there's a little bit of additional information about Marge in her majorette career. Marge was the first majorette of color to lead the award-winning Golden Triangles, and the Swissville High School Marching Band. Even at a young age, Marge was at the forefront. A job as a clerk at AT&T was the start of a 30-year career with the company, where she worked in the areas of customer service, marketing, program management, and human resource management. Always highly regarded for her leadership style, problem-solving skills, and positive results in the business units where she worked, she retired in 1999 with the title of Business Operations Manager. Several years after her retirement, she started a second career in property management with Long & Foster, where she worked for more than a decade. For her family, friends, and associates, she was a role model to emulate. She was smart, funny, stylish, fiercely loyal, opinionated, discriminating, and discerning, and also principled. In fact, her brother-in-law called her the best sister-in-law on the planet. Our beloved sister was a trusted ear, a wise soul, and a comfort in the storms of life. She was the perfect person to consult with when faced with a problem or if you needed someone to confide in, because her response would always, always be based on your best interest. Never, however, mistake her kindness for weakness. Yes, her arsenal included a warm smile, but it also included a withering look and a biting wit that could cut anybody. Yes, including her siblings, down to size. In other words, she did not suffer fools gladly. For example, heaven help you if you were on the receiving end of a sentence started with, "Help me understand." Marge was known for her consummate style and love of travel, particularly to places known for sunshine and warmth. In addition, she was a world-class shopper, a lover of cats, and a maker of a mean sweet potato pie. Marge was preceded in death by her parents, Georgia Daniels Purifoy and Edgar Lee Wiley. She passed away on November 3rd, 2020, leaving behind to cherish her memory siblings Patricia Purifoy, Leslie Wiley, husband Larry Irving, and Edgar Lee Wiley Jr. She also leaves a beloved bonus mom, Faith Wiley Matthews, nephew Keith Kenneth Glover, and niece Jennifer Anderson, husband Alan. And she also leaves behind a host of cousins and dear friends. Thank you.
God is watching over you and me. I sing because my soul is a happy.
In attendance at this hour and those who are following the service on Zoom, I count it a great privilege and a blessing to be chosen to deliver the eulogy for our beloved sister Marjorie Wiley Crawford. Death is always a sad occasion, but we know we have a God who cares and who is concerned about us. I want to extend my deepest sympathy to every member of the family, especially to the matriarch of the family, our good friend and beloved sister Faye Wiley. Praise God for your courage and your strength. And I would like to extend sympathy to the immediate members of the family. Sister Patricia and Sister Leslie and her husband, and also to the brother of Marjorie. To all of you, we say may God be with you and may God bless you. A brief message for your comfort today is coming from the book of 2 Thessalonians chapter 4 and the verses 13 and 14. Paul the Apostle extend this message to each one of you today by saying, brothers, we do not want you to be ignorant about those who fall asleep and to grieve like the rest of men who have no hope. For we believe that Jesus died and rose again, and so we believe that God will bring with Jesus those who have fallen asleep in him. The word the Lord sent to you today is to grieve with hope. Grieve, family members, with hope. Grieving is a natural emotional process, is the response that we experience in the face of loss. The loss can be a job, it can be a relationship, and it can be a major one. The loss of a family member, the loss of a loved one. Now, experts say there are stages in grieving all of us go through. We begin by denying what's happened, and some people will experience anger. Others will be depressed, and ultimately will reach the stage called acceptance. What I'm proposing to you this morning is that you don't grieve like the rest of the world, the rest of men, that you go through all those stages. But let God take you to that last stage, which is acceptance. Let God help you to know that He is sovereign, that His will be done. And when we accept what's happened, our life starts to move forward. We start to leave the jungle of sadness and depression behind us. Please, this afternoon, grieve with hope. Let me give you 3 brief steps to help you in the process. When you grieve with hope, you grieve prayerfully. Second, when you grieve with hope, you grieve thankfully. And grieving with hope help you to grieve expectantly. Yes, grieving is so much easier when you take everything to the Lord in prayer. Grieving is so much lighter when you remember that you have a friend in Jesus. All of grief and all your sin, take them all to the Lord in prayer. There is a great song in the Church of God. It said, keep praying and toiling on. He said, if grief seems more than you can bear, keep praying and toiling on. I want to remind you that praying lightens every care. Keep praying and toiling on. For the Lord, our Savior, He has great sympathy for struggling mortals such as we. And family, He will give you victory over depression, over sadness, and over anger this afternoon. The second point to grieve with hope is grieve thankfully. Look back and remember with thanksgiving your loved one, your sister. Remember how the Lord has blessed her. Remember her achievements. Remember a productive life with AT&T. Remember a word of wisdom, a word of encouragement while she was here with you. That will help you very much to break through the clouds of despair and distress and dispiration. Yes, sir. Grieve prayerfully. Yes, grieve thankfully. And do not forget to grieve expectantly. And that's what Paul teaches us. Paul tells us, do not grieve like the world, because we have hope. Because we have God. And Paul reminds us that Jesus died. Jesus, he rose again. And that God will bring with Jesus all those who have fallen asleep. So today, we have a hope within our soul, and it is a hope that is brighter than the sunshine. And Paul teaches us in what will happen when Jesus came back, the second coming of the Lord. We, as God people, we treasure that hope, we treasure that expectation that Jesus is coming back for his people, for those like Marjorie and countless others who preceded her. Jesus is coming back. And remember those three steps. This is how Paul described it in the following verses of 2 Thessalonians. He said the first step, the Lord himself will come with a shout, with a loud command. Step one. Step two, all those who died in the Lord, when they hear that shout, when they hear the voice, the sound of the trumpet of God, the Bible said that they will rise and they will be caught up in the clouds. Step two. Well, those of us who are left behind, well, God will not forget about us. The Bible said that we're going to also be caught up in the air, to in the clouds, to meet Jesus in the air, and there we will be with him forever. Yes, we have a hope that Jesus is the resurrection and the life, and he's coming back for you. Yes, as human beings, we do grieve, but we don't grieve like the rest of the world. We grieve with hope. There is the example of a man who can help you grieve this morning. His name was Horatio Spafford. He really had faced great trouble. He had to grieve, not for one person. He lost daughters. Not one daughter. He has to grieve not for two daughters. He had to grieve not for three, but for four, because of a shipwreck that took place. The ship sunk and all four daughters died. But he was able to look up to the hill and find help and say, it is well with my soul. Is it well with you today? Make it that way. talk to yourself and say, it is well with my soul. Your beloved sister, she's preceding you in death. We all will follow the same path. But meanwhile, while we are here, grieve with hope and remember that with Jesus, it is well with your soul. Let us pray. Father, we bless you and we thank you that because you live today, we can say that it is well with us. Even in the valley of the shadow of death, we do not fear because you are with us. Once again, let your hand of mercy touch each member of this family right now and help them to grieve with hope and help them, Lord, to have the song of hope in the heart and in the mind that with Jesus, it is well with our soul. And to you, we shall give glory and praise forever and ever. Amen. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord strengthen you. May the Lord encourage you as you move forward and upward. At this time, we will do the committal part of the service. Man that is born of a woman has but a short time to live and is full of misery. He come up and is cut down like a flower. He flieth as it were a shadow and never continue in one stay. In the midst of life, we are in death. Of whom may we seek for succor but of thee, O Lord, who for our sin art justly displeased? Yet, O Lord, God most holy, O Lord most mighty, O holy and most merciful Savior, deliver us not into the bitter pains of eternal death. Thou knowest, Lord, the secrets of our hearts. Shut not thy merciful ears to our prayer, but spare us, Lord, most holy, O God, most holy, O holy and merciful Savior, thou most worthy judge eternal, suffer us not at our last hour for any pains of death to fall from thee. For as much it has pleased Almighty God in his wise providence to take out of this world the soul of our deceased sister Marjorie Wiley Crawford, we therefore commit her body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, looking for the general resurrection of the last day and the life of the world to come, through our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose second coming in glorious majesty to judge the world, the earth, and the sea, shall give up the dead and the corruptible bodies of those who sleep in him shall be changed and made like unto his own glorious body according to the mighty working whereby is able to subdue all things unto himself. I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, write, from henceforth, blessed are the dead who die in the Lord. Even so says the Spirit, for the rest from their labors. Let's take together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. And the power and the glory forever. Amen. Let's receive the benediction. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit keep you, strengthen you from now and forevermore. Amen. God bless you.